Do you want to live in a society where artificial intelligence decide you're guilty due to your demographic identities? Yes, it was happened in city of Rotterdam, Netherlands. Every year, the city gave some 30,000 people welfare benefits to make rent, buy food, and pay essential bills. And every year, thousands of people investigated under suspicious of committing benefit fraud. In response, in 2017, city deployed AI to generate risk score for everyone on welfare. Being female, being young, having kids, and not passed Dutch language test has been scored high risk and flagged for investigation. Whom do you blame? The AI or some human? It's difficult because number of parties responsible for eventual development of AI into this world could be large. The inventor, the operator, the manufacturer, the designer, and so on. I mean, no, right? This is what a society without AI regulation look like. Understanding this risk, the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development stated that over 170 countries shape their national AI policies. But the real question is, will the national level AI policies suit to local level? There come my research to develop an AI policy framework which could be flexibly changed to each local authority. It's a complex process, but complex doesn't mean impossible. First, I'll investigate the opportunities and challenges of adopting AI in local government, the available policy framework, and their alignment with national AI policies. Also, my framework will incorporate two main actors' perspective of our society. First, all of you, the public, as y'all going to be the end users of this product. Second, the policymakers, such as politicians, city managers. They may or may not have knowledge on AI, but it's impossible to avoid them as they're having the authority and financial power on implementation. My research findings will facilitate the policymakers on their AI implementation and digital transformation. Once, the Google CEO Sundar Pichai said, AI will have profound impact on humanity than fire, electricity, and internet. So, it's time for us to get down in the field to face this social disparate just right with proper policies and ethical standards. Thank you.